Hi everyone. In this lecture, we'll learn auto layout and stack view. The central goal is to design a responsive UI that looks great on various iOS devices. Before diving into the lecture, let's talk a little bit about Xcode. In Xcode 8.1, by default, iPhone apps are designed and run on iPhone 7, as you can see down at the bottom here. If you want, you can choose to design an app on other devices. Now, as you can see, when we switch to design our app on iPhone SE, the UI elements no longer look as we expect. Similarly, if we switch to a smaller screen, things look even worse. It's because we have been designing those elements for iPhone 7. If we build and run the app on iPhone 7, everything will look just like we expect. The size of the UI elements that we designed perfectly fit the size of an iPhone 7. So they will display nicely on an iPhone 7 screen. All right. However, as we mentioned in one of the previous lectures, if we build and run the app on a different device, well, things will look off. That's why we need auto layout to make things display nicely on various iOS devices. Okay, good. The app looks great. Now let's build and run the app on iPhone 6S, for example. As the screen of an iPhone 6 Plus is larger than that of an iPhone 7, things won't show up as nicely as we want them to. By the way, if we want to use the simulator to be bigger, you can hit Command 2 to enlarge it. Okay, now, the screen of the device that the app is running on is bigger than that the app is designed for. What do you think the app looks like now? Okay, it's running. Let's see how it looks. Oh yeah, the screen is now bigger, so the UI elements don't fit anymore. For example, all the elements are off to the left, leaving a large space on the right, although they're supposed to be centered. Alright, that's enough for motivation. We now know that we need auto layout to make the app look just as we expect on various devices. Let's now learn to use it. Intuitively, to make things responsive and dynamic, the key is relativity instead of absoluteness. So the distance and size units should be relative. Precisely, distance is measured in point instead of pixel. In retina devices, a point equals 2 pixels, whereas in non-retina devices, it is 1 pixel. So things will be scaled nicely, and we don't need to worry about resolution. Furthermore, the system needs enough information on the location and/or size of the UI elements to display them correctly. We need left, right, top, and bottom information to fully locate a 2D object. So let's take this option as an example and learn how to use auto layout to correctly perform positioning and sizing it. First, let's open the utility area. We'll stay quite some time in it. These look good, so we won't touch them. These things down here are the main tools for using auto layout. Let's go over them briefly. We use the align tool right here to tell the system how to align the UI elements. For example, the last two constraints specify how we want to align a UI element with respect to whatever containing it. The first one specifies horizontal alignment, and the second one is about vertical alignment. Now, the pin tool right here. Let us locate an element relatively to its closest neighbors. These numbers are in point. Now, let's say we want to make this button touch the two edges in the bottom of the screen. We will locate it 0 point from the left and 0 point from the right, with respect to its closest neighbor, which is the super view in this case. This is the view we're building things on. Similarly, locate it 0 point from the bottom edge. Now, a great way to keep track of the process is using the size inspector of the element. Here, we can see the left constraint we've just added, the right constraint, and the bottom constraint. You can see this is not the super view, so let's click on it. All right. We can then see this constraint in more detail. All right. This says the reference object is the bottom layout guide, which is the bottom line here. Notice that it does not belong to the super view here. This storyboard UI view controller also consists of top and bottom layout guides. right? If you don't want a view cover the status bar, locate it below the top layout guide, which is at 20 points from the top. Note that the super view is automatically positioned relatively to the switch view button. All right, let's run the app and see. Again, if things get too complicated, we can always use this tool to keep track of the constraints. As we let this button touch the two edges of the super view, we should expect that it's centered on the view. All right, good, just as we designed. Now, a great way to lay things out is to fill up the elements. So in the attribute inspector of this button, let's change its background color to something visible. All right, now, let's build the app and see. The trick we've just used is for us to verify visually that the constraints are set up as we expect. Okay, now, the constraints look obvious to us. This button, indeed, touches the three edges as we designed. Note that the one in the storyboard doesn't look quite right, but more on this shortly. Also, the actual button on the running app looks thin. The reason is that one more piece of information is still missing. To fully specify a 2D object, intuitively, we need left, right, bottom, and top information. So one way to fix this issue is to specify the button height by holding Control and drag the button vertically. A menu will pop up. Let's choose the height option. Now, click on the blue vertical line on the right. The button height is now correctly set to whatever you design on the storyboard. You can also see that constraint by looking at the size inspector of the button. The button now has a new constraint, saying its height should always be 44 points. All right, good. Before building the app, notice the orange lines on the storyboard. This means the sizing stuff we did on the storyboard before is different from what we set using auto layout. In this case, we can use this tool to update the storyboard stuff to match what we do using auto layout. It's a new tool shipped with Xcode 8.1. It's probably a feature that is used so frequently that Apple has to move it out from here. All right. Actually, it's moved out from the Resolve Auto Layout Issues tool, which is the rightmost tool here. Alright, so if you use the Update Frames tool, the Storyboard button will be updated to match the constraints. Okay, let's see. We're good, actually. Let's run the app to see how it looks now. We specified the left, right, bottom, and top, or precisely the height information of the button. The system should now be able to locate it easily. All right, great. Now, in the button attribute inspector, let's drop this white color and use a clear background, as in the design. We use the white background color only for visually testing out our constraints. This is a good trick to use when laying out the UI. All right. Okay. Alright, we now use auto layout on the Instagram label. Similarly, we need four pieces of information to fully position this UI label, like how far it should be from the top edge or things like that. To do so, let's again use the pin tool. First of all, do you notice the constrain to margins option? If we uncheck it, we specify the distance from an object to the edge of the screen. If we check this option, we specify this distance against the lines at the margins of the scene. These lines are simply some sort of guideline for us to make sure our content doesn't touch the edges. We actually allow some padding to the edges of the scene when designing the UI elements. So, here we don't need this option, hence leave it unchecked. So for this text label, we first specify how far it is from the top. For horizontal position, we can add these two constraints. However, we'll use a feature in the Align tool. As the width of the label corresponds to the text size, it's a good idea to simply horizontally center the label by checking this Horizontally in Container option. Its width is known, which is sort of the text size, and it's horizontally centered. So, the system can locate it horizontally. All right. You can still use the pin tool to add leading space to the left and trailing space to the right. However, you must be careful. Make sure the numbers are right and they add up nicely. Right now, the leading and trailing spaces are not equal, as you can see here. So, the text label might not be horizontally centered correctly, even though we already had enough horizontal information. So, in this case, it's probably a good idea to use the Align tool. Alright, let's run the app to see if the Instagram text label displays as we expect. The horizontal information is okay. Furthermore, vertically, the system knows its top position and also knows its height, which is sort of the text height. Alright, yeah, that's enough information and it looks good now. Now, let's move on to the login UI elements. You can certainly use auto layout to position each of them individually, as we did to the others, by like adding just enough information to each of the elements to fully locate it. However, these elements are very similar in sizes and stuff to some extent, so a great way to position them is to group all of them together and treat the composition as a single view. We can then perform auto layout on this composite element. All right. To do that, we utilize a concept in iOS called StackView. It's a great tool for auto laying out a structured group of UI elements. Structure here can be like the elements have the same width, or the spacing is even, as in this case. To use StackView, first hold Command and click on all elements we want to group. Then, click on the Embed in Stack button down here. Alright, good. These elements are now grouped together. Okay. They probably don't look as we expect, but don't worry. We'll tell Xcode how we want to characterize them. Alright, now, let's set the desired height of the email and password text fields by holding Command and selecting both of them. Then, specify their heights in the pin tool. We use the default height of text fields. Next, we set the login button height to whatever we want, which is 44 points as we did without auto layout. There's really nothing fancy here. We simply set their heights back to when they weren't embedded in the stack view. All right. Good. To choose the stack view, we can select it here. You can see it consists of these three UI elements. Now, as before, we want the distances between the three as 20 points evenly. We can specify that in the attribute inspector of the stack view. Alright, great. They start to look just as we want them. Again, this stack view is just like a regular view, so we can perform auto layout on it. Now in the design, we want these elements to be both vertically and horizontally centered. We sort of did that without auto layout. Again, to center a view, we can utilize this Align tool. We can also update the storyboard to match up the constraints right now. This option lets us instantly update the frames on the storyboard. This is just another way of updating frames besides the one we used before. Alright, let's pause a moment to look back at what we've been doing so far. The switch button is good. The Instagram label only has enough constraints. So, let's see what the system knows about the stack view. So, select the stack view, then go to its size inspector. Okay, the stack view is vertically centered. Its height is known, which consists of the login element heights and their spacing. So, its vertical information is fully specified. That means we now have enough and no redundant vertical constraints for all of the UI elements. Alright, there's only one thing left. We still need to specify the horizontal information for this stack view. Unlike the Instagram text label, its width fit its text content size, which is known. So horizontally centering it is enough. However, the width of the stack view is unspecified up to this point. So the system doesn't know how to locate it horizontally. Now, recall that in the previous lectures, as in the design, we let these three elements have the same width, with 20 points spacing from the screen edges. So let's add these constraints to the stack view. we'll constrain it to the edges instead of the margins, with a distance of 20 points. We'll update the storyboard frames here too. Okay, great. Looks pretty good. All right, let's see if we're missing anything. Okay, vertical constraints are good. Horizontal constraints are good. All right, yeah, I think we're good. You can check the constraints yourself to see if we have enough constraints. Left, right, vertical, and horizontal centered. You can see that in the size inspector too. Okay, looks pretty good. Let's check it out. During the rest of the lecture, we'll use Perform Auto Layout on the sign-up view. You're encouraged to pause the lecture to do it by yourself first. Okay, here it is. Looks good, right? Let's switch to the sign-up view. Yeah, we need to do something to make it right. Let's do it. We'll take care of the image view first. We first specify how far we want it to be from the top of the top layout guide, and center it horizontally. As you can see in its size inspector, we still need more information. Again, unlike the Instagram text label, in which the size of the label can be determined by the text size, which is known. The size of the image view is not known, just like the text fields or the buttons, unless we specify the corresponding constraints, which are the width and the height constraints. So the current constraints are not enough to characterize it. As with the switch button, we can add these constraints by holding Control and dragging it down. Hold Command and select the width and height options, then add these constraints. Alright, good. Let's step back and see. We know where it is from the top and know its height, so we can fully characterize it vertically. We know its width and know that it's horizontally centered, so the horizontal information is good too. Alright, great. Now let's use StackView to auto lay out these signup elements. Hold Command and select all, then embed them into a stack view. Now Command select the three text fields and then add their text constraints, because they have the same height. Next, add the height constraint to the signup button. Its height is 44 points, as in the design, to allow users easy to touch and also to make it look balanced. Alright, good. Now we can add auto layout for the entire stack. We can center it both horizontally and vertically by adding these two constraints. Add update frames right in here. Alright, great. Now we need to specify its sizes. There is not a unique way of doing so. One way is to specify its distances to the left and right screen edges by adding its left and right constraints. You can update frames to see the effect right away. Alright, great. Now these stack elements are too close to each other, so go to the attribute inspector of the stack view. Set the spacing to 20 points to add space to these elements as before. Alright. Good. Now move on to this switching button. Set its left, right, and bottom constraints. We then need one more vertical constraint. So far, we only add a bottom constraint to it, so we still need a top constraint. One way is to simply fix its height. Alright, good. The system now knows everything about this button. You can see these constraints in the size inspector of this button. Okay, these orange lines mean the storyboard hasn't updated the changes. We can simply click the Update Frames button to resolve this issue. Or, we can use a shortcut by holding Command and hitting the equal sign. Alright, not that one. Let's redo it. Okay, it's Command, Option, and the equal sign. Alright, good. We're now happy with the layout, so let's check it out. Right. Fantastic. Pretty cool, huh? All right. Next time, we'll work with tab bars. See you then.